Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. In this video, we take an in-depth look at the 3D keyer in the Flame products. This highly regarded keying tool was introduced in the modular keyer and eventually made its way into the main batch flow graph. The unique functionality of the 3D keyer is the RGB viewer that represents the colors of an image as a 3D histogram. This allows you to analyze the colors in an image and pull keys with great accuracy. For those of you who have mastered it, it is an amazing tool to have at your disposal. But most people who encounter it find it daunting as soon as the RGB viewer appears. This video will take you through a keying example that will examine the controls and concepts behind the 3D keyer workflow. We will focus solely on pulling a key and not other aspects such as color suppression, light wrapping, or compositing. That is something you can do on your own after using the 3D keyer. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. We'll look at the 3D keyer in batch, but it also is still available in the modular keyer. Looking at the 3D keyer node, you will see that it only has a single keying input and a single mat output. So unlike some of the other Flame keyers, you use the 3D keyer to just generate a mat. Then you composite it with a different compositing node, like Comp, for example. So go ahead and connect the provided source clip into the 3D keyer. If you double-click and press F4 to see the result view, the mat output will be white because no colors have been sampled. So press F1 for the front keying source. You'll find yourself toggling between F1 and F4 when working with the 3D keyer. To the top right, you can see the RGB viewer with the 3D color histogram. This is not required, but just so that we can get up close and personal with the RGB viewer, pan the image to the left. There are three hotkeys you can use to manipulate the 3D viewer. Press Alt and you can move the RGB viewer. Pressing Shift, you can zoom the RGB viewer in and out. Finally, pressing Control, you can rotate the RGB view to get a different angle of the 3D histogram. The X, Y, and Z axis represent the red, green, and blue components within the RGB color space. And the histogram is a representation of the image's colors mapped out in 3D space. If you scrub the time bar, the RGB view will update to the colors of the current frame. So this is live all the time. Now the cubes of color show the color distribution of the image. This means that you can move around the RGB view and isolate specific colors relative to the task. As you can see, there is a much higher concentration of green because this is an obvious green screenshot. It's worth noting that as you perform operations such as tolerance and softness, additional 3D elements will appear in the RGB view. These elements are interactive and will help you tweak the mat even further. If you want to change the look of the RGB viewer, you can do so through the Preferences menu and various hotkeys. We'll use some of these hotkeys during the video. If at any time you want to reset the RGB view to its default position, just click the Home button. So let's sample the color and increase the tolerance. Tolerance is mapped to the T hotkey if it is not already set in the Sampling pull-down menu. You can either click to sample a pixel or hold Ctrl and drag a box selection. The sampling is accumulative. Now you won't see very much in the front view, but it's easier to pick the color. Switch to the result view. So this is the mat with no softness added. You can keep increasing the tolerance, but you do not have to go crazy and sample every pixel of green. All you really need is a small sample and you build it from there. Now let's look at the histogram. You probably don't see anything because the tolerance range is hidden by the histogram. Press H to hide the histogram and you should see a small oval shape that is the tolerance element. The tolerance display is set to ellipsoid, but you could change it to a wireframe or a cloud model or simply turn it off. This is just a visual display. If you toggle the histogram on and off, you will see that it falls within the majority of green. Next, let's sample some softness. Change the sampling mode to softness or press the S hotkey. Looking back at the front view, the softening will occur in the hair and the motion blur of the hand. Hold Ctrl and drag a box selection over those regions. Avoid sampling areas where the key should not be soft, otherwise you'll spend more time tweaking the mat. Go back to the result view to see the current key. Looking at the RGB viewer, the softness element surrounds the tolerance. So a general softness has been applied, but you can tweak this much further with a few different options. You could click on the image and increase the softness range. Or, if you hold Alt and click, you can decrease the softness range. To refine the softness, hold the V hotkey, and you can click and drag on localized points to increase or decrease the amount of softness within those areas. Or under the softness controls, you can proportionately scale the softness using sliders. There are also individual scaling sliders to grow the softness element in X, Y, and Z, which will affect more red, green, or blue colors. In all instances, the RGB viewer grows the softness element to consider more colors to be affected by softening. But one aspect of the image that always affects softness is the noise or grain. To improve the softness, we first need to take a noise sample. Hold N and drag a box selection over the softened area with noise. The matte result should not change as a result of the sampling. Now change the proportional button to minimize noise. Increasing the slider will start removing noise from the matte. Finer details should become much clearer as the softness element adjusts to the noise reduction. But it can result in over-softening the key and losing wanted detail. So hold the V hotkey and drag the image to adjust the softness in specific areas, but the noise reduction will remain. If you wish to refine the noise further on screen, hold Alt N and drag on the image until you get the appropriate look. This scales the softness element according to the noise sample. So hopefully your result is not looking too bad. Now, a very big advantage is that you can operate the softness in either RGB or YUV color space. They actually operate independently of each other, so you can experiment with both and choose the best one. So let's go to YUV and give that a go. It's worth mentioning that tolerance will be the same in both color modes, so this only affects the softness. As before, we need to sample the softness. Hold Ctrl and draw a box selection around the finer details. Now let's get a noise sample. Hold N and drag a box selection over the grey area of the mat. Switch to minimize noise and adjust the slider. Next, switch to proportional and adjust the softness element. And finally, hold V and start dragging on different points within the image to refine localized areas. So there we have the YUV softness. You can toggle between the YUV and RGB color space, and both will retain their values. Now the RGB softness tends to be a bit more accurate than YUV. This is because YUV removes more noise than RGB, so softening will be less accurate. However, it is still great for shadows and transparencies like glass, etc. At the end of the day, whichever key gives you the best result will be the one you choose. I'll go with the RGB result. Let's quickly see how this looks as a composite. In Batch, drag out a comp node and connect the image, the 3D keyer mat, and the background. If we look at the result of the comp node and scrub the time bar, you can see that the 3D keyer has already done quite a good job on the key. So in this video, we've learnt about the RGB viewer and the color histogram. You've seen how to build the tolerance and softness elements within the 3D representation to apply the key. In the next video, we start manipulating these elements within the RGB viewer to have even more control over the mat. Remember to check it out. comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos.